Okay, welcome back. So let's continue this new system. So over on our inventory slot, over on click, we have now probably finished our entire right mouse button. There's bound to be some bugs. However, the bugs shouldn't be too difficult to figure out if there is any at all. This is our right click. And I'm gonna make that green. That one is now good to go. A little bit prettier. Maybe like that. That's our right click. Now let's focus on our left click. So our left click is going to be starting out the same way. So do we have something in the slot? If we do not have something in the slot, well, do we have anything picked up? If we do not have anything picked up, we can return. However, if we do have something picked up, we want to place the entirety of the slot, the pickup. So we're going to place item. Place item is very simple. We're just going to get our set the item input index of the slot that we are trying to drop it on or clicking on, which is the in our index over here. The pickup widget we need to get a hold of, so get pickup widget. We can get the item off the pickup widget, get the quantity, not the quantity text, get the quantity like so, and we can get our pickup widget and we can invalidate the pickup widget. Return, compile, click. And do we have something picked up? Yeah, we want to place that item then. Right. We have something picked up. Place it in our slot. So. Nothing picked up. Do nothing. Like so. Beautiful. Back in our click. If we do have something in the slot, then we want to check if it's a valid stackable slot. Yeah, that should be fine. Valid stackable slot, branch. Is it a valid stackable? If it is not a valid stackable, then we want to slot swap to pick up a slot. Swap it. Or if it is, I'm going to add to stack. Have we made that? We've added add one to stack. I think we might have it on drop. Merge stacks, we called it. But that's, so the merge stacks is probably not going to work for us. Because the merge stacks handles with the drag drop system. So we need to add a new function. This one is going to be add to stack. Click. Add stack click is going to go directly into a branch. Now the condition of this branch is going to be a little bit tricky. But get item info index. It's going to be the index, our index. We're going to check if the quantity plus the pickup quantity. So get pickup. Get a quantity. So it's our quantity plus that quantity less than or equal to, let's move this down there, less than or equal to the max stack size. So we can just get this defaults break max stack size. If that is true, very simple, we are simply going to get our inventory ref. We're going to set item input index. Index is our index. We're going to set it to the addition over here. So let's get this like so. Item is the item. And that's it for that. Now we can get our picked up widget. We can update all info onto that. that we can return. So now we can either update all info or we can invalidate. Probably just invalidate. That is basically doing the same thing, right? Our update all info, if we were to do it that way, we were setting that to blank. Invalidate sets that to blank as well. So it doesn't really matter for us which one we use. Invalidate looks a bit better though. Okay, beautiful. That's it for our true branch. And we can probably test that. No, we can't. We're not going to test it. Okay. Now we got to get our href, get our picked up widget. Update all info this time. Because now we don't want to set it to null. We don't want to wipe it out. Get the item info. Item goes into item. Quantity plus our picked up widgets quantity. Actually, we can get all info plus the picked up quantity minus defaults break minus the max stack size is going to give us the quantity that we want to put there on our pickup widget. Right, so our quantity plus the quantity of a pickup widget minus the max stack size. So that's going to give us a remainder, and we're going to put that there. After that, we're going to set item info at index on ourselves. And since it's ourselves, we need to put the index in, our index in. We're going to set that to be defaults of the max stack size. We check if, let's do it separately. So is our info, our quantity plus ink quantity less than or equal to max stack size? It is not less than or equal to. We calculate the remainder, the overflow of our, we calculate the overflow and set the information of pickup widget to the overflow, then set our slot to max stack. It is less than or equal to, we just set the info to the addition of that and invalidate our pickup widget. Beautiful. That's it for this function. I can go back to click. If it's a valid stackable slot, if it's not, we're going to swap it. However, if it is, we're going to add to stack click. Valid, add to stack. Wow. And that should theoretically be it for our other branch as well. So if I now go here, that doesn't actually seem to work. Let's see what's happening. Okay, so it is the invalidate that is most likely causing the problem. So if I go to click and I go to add stack, where do you get all info here? I'm gonna move things a bit down, plus the quantity there. This should not make any difference. However, it might be the invalidate, guys. Update all info. There we go. It was the invalidate. So our invalidate is... Where is that error coming in? Yeah, it's on a valid one. It's checking that the item, because the item, the max stack size, this one, it is trying to validate something that is not not valid. Let's just see if continue to see if this works. So that should be working just fine. Okay, let's remake some stuff. Okay, so our slot validity is fine. Instead of validate on our picked up, we're going into our inventory slot and we are adding a new function called already picked up item. It's a pure function, has an output of a valid. Get our HUDref, get picked up widget, get item, valid class, and we're just gonna plug that into there. It's pure, yeah. Back onto click now. We're gonna change out this one for the already picked up item one. The place one item is looking fine. Let's also check the remove one. That's the remove one. I'm not going to decrement that int anymore. I'm going to do quantity minus one. Oh. Quantity minus one. That is the new quantity. And then this one should go down to invalidate. Invalidate is good. Okay, let's go back to the inventory slot on click and keep bugging our way over here. Place one item, slot validity. This one also needs to be changed up for already picked up item. If on a grab half stack, we're updating all info to the correct info. Yes. We're going to update all info. Update all info should be fine. Back in our inventory slot on our click event. Our valid stackable slot is using our WBP pickup widget. I'm going to grab this one down here again. Then I'm going to do defaults out of this one. I'm going to remove this default. Break open that. Move those over. It does not matter. They are the same thing. I am just setting it up like this now. Back on our click event. If it's not a valid stackable, we're going to swap it. Let's go and check that. We're caching our info. We're getting our HUD drive. We're setting the info of ourselves to the info of the HUD, the thing we want. And then updating that, that should be fine. Back to click event again. That should be taking care of our right click. So our left click, we're checking slot validity. Fine. We are are we missing something? We are, right? Okay, so slot valid. If we are not valid, we want to check if we have already picked up an item. I think we're just missing one thing, actually. I think I'm seeing it. It's up here. We're missing a check. We need to check if we have already picked up an item over here as well. Do we already have an item picked up? No, don't do anything. Place item. Okay. Move this up. This check. It needs to go in here as well. Do we have something in the slot? Yes. Do we already have something picked up? If we do not already have something picked up, we can now pick up the item. Yeah, this is where the problem was. So, pick up item. Get item info index. Index is our index. Get the pickup widget. Set all info. Info. Update all info. To be that of our item, our quantity. our index, and let's refresh ourselves. This one should theoretically update itself, yeah, so we don't have to worry about that. Then we want to set item info index. We do not have anything picked up, we just want to, well, let's try to do the pickup. It's not gonna, this is for the eventual, what's it called? The eventual, if we're adding console support. That's why we're getting this pickup sorted right away. So if we already have an item picked up, if we don't, we're gonna pick it up, we're gonna return. Or if we do, we can proceed into our valids. If I now click play, if I do this, that's gonna handle everything like I want it to. It's not stacking anymore, that's why I can't do anything. Okay, there we go, we got an error. Let's try to replicate that error. Okay, so the error is if I let's play. Move that one there, and then I saw it on the second slot, so I can boom, 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 left click. It's placing the item. However, after it's placing the item, it's not invalidating properly. Maybe our invalidate is just dog shit. Let's, instead of invalidate, call our update all info. Update all info to be blank. There we go. That took care of that problem. And that should take care of all of those problems, actually. Valid stackable. Yeah, so now we, because we fucked up the other one, right? So this is valid stackable. Now we're checking for this one. So valid stackable slot, we're going to rename that to be valid stackable slot pickup widget, like so. And then we're going to duplicate that to be just valid stackable slot drag drop. So for the drag drop, we need to get the item that we're dragging, making sure that is the same. Oh, because it's the pickup widget, sorry. We need the drag drop in there. Okay, there we go. So now we are back again to a functioning drag drop. We also have the accessibility of our right click. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this part of the system. This is part one completed of our setting up our drag drop. In the next episode, we are probably going to work with implementing a chest system, and also probably, maybe, I don't know, the save system. We'll see. We'll see how far we get. Okay, until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye.